Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Good afternoon, Miss.
How are you, girls?
Fine.
All right, very good.
Very good.
Excellent, Karen. You're very good. All right, girls, let me go on with the PPT. I'm going to share it with you. All right, so thanks God, yesterday we finished section 4, right? So I hope you already finished with that section. If you have any questions, you can make those questions, all right? I'll be here just to help you with anything that you need. Now, today we're going to start section 5. Yay, it's the last section. You just finished this section, and then you'll go to the last exam, and that's it, all right? You finish your level. Now, let's go. Today is class 13. Let me go over here. We are going to have sort of as a review, okay? Un pequeño review. Okay. Give me 1 second, girls. All right, let's continue, girls. Let's see, what do we have for today's class? We have these guiding answers. Of course, as I told you, we already finished with section 4, but that doesn't mean that we cannot have a recalling previous learning, right? Or try to recall the content learned. So let's see, I'm going to have Genevieve, please, you are going to be the side of go hiking, and Karen Heyman, you are the side of go swimming. Vamos a ir una y una, okay?
Go hiking.
Go swimming.
Have a fun.
Have a picnic.
Meet new people.
Meet old friends.
Play tennis.
Play volleyball.
See a movie.
See a play.
Take a class.
Take a pictures.
Take pictures. Excellent. Very good. Thank you, girls. Let me have, let's see, Lady, you are the side of go hiking, and Maria Siguenza, you are the side of go swimming, please.
Okay, go hiking.
Go swimming.
Have fun.
Have a picnic.
Meet new people.
Meet old friends.
Play tennis.
Play volleyball.
See a movie.
See a play.
Take a glass.
Take picture.
All right, there you go. Excellent. Now let's go with Anita. Hello, Anita. Let's see. You are the side of go hiking.
Okay.
And let me see. Karen Martinez, you are the side of go swimming. Please, one and one.
Okay. Go hiking.
Let's see. Vamos a ver si le contesta Karen.
¿Martínez o Germán?
No,
Germán. Ah, ok, perdón, no le escuché.
Don't worry, no se preocupe.
Go swimming.
Have fun.
Have a picnic.
Meet new people.
Meet old friends.
Play tennis.
Play volleyball.
See a movie.
See a play.
Take a class.
Take pictures.
There you go. Excellent. Thank you, girls. Now, let's see who else do we have in the classroom. Let me check. I have, I think that Fatima is busy. Okay, so we're going to move on, girls. Excellent. Remember, please, if you use go in simple past, what would it be in my verb? ¿Cómo sería go in simple past?
When.
Mm-hmm. Excellent, there you go. ¿Y si quiere utilizar have?
Have.
Have, excellent. What about meet?
Met.
Met, uh-huh. What if I want to say play, but in past?
Played.
Played. Excellent. In, sí?
Help.
Mm-hmm. Take.
Took.
There you go, excellent, excellent girls. It's good that we know how to use these verbs even in present, the same way as in past, all right? Excellent, let's move on to the following. Reading weekend stories. Let me check. I think that yesterday, van a disculpar si ven un lapicito por aquí, right? Pero es que se me arruinó el mouse, entonces con mi, es una laptop. Y mis dedos, yo soy bien como pegajosita de los dedos. Entonces ocupo un lapicito para estarlo moviendo, right? Así que por eso me dio risa. Let's see, vamos a tener reading weekend stories. Ayer solo Lady y Natalia creo que pasaron en el reading, ¿ok? So, let me check. I'm going to have María Sigüenza, please tell me the reading about Kelly. Anita, usted va a ser Robert. Y Karen Heyman, usted va a ser Eddie. Action.
I had a great weekend. I went to my best friend, Ellen Guerin. She got married at home. All her friends and family went. She looked fantastic. She wore a beautiful dress. After the ceremony, her parents served a wonderful meal. I am really happy for her. I really like her husband.
Excellent. Very good. Thank you. Let's go with Robert.
I had an awful weekend. My friends and I went to a rock concert. I had a terrible time. It took 3 hours to drive there. I didn't like the music at all. And after the concert ended, our car broke down. I called my parents and they come and got us. We finally got home at 10 this morning. I am so tired.
That's correct. Very good. Excellent. Este es el que más tiene verbs in simple past, right? Excellent. Let's go with Karen. You are Ari.
I had an interesting weekend. I went camping for the first time. My friends took me. We left on Saturday and drove to the campsite, okay. First, we put up the tent. Then we...
Built? Then?
Pardon?
Then we built
a fire.
Fire.
Fire. Cooking the dinner and told stories. We got up early on Sunday and went fishing. I caught a fish. I didn't really like camping, but I learned a lot.
That's correct. Excellent, Karen. Now, if you notice something in these readings, algo que podemos destacar o extraer de estos readings es el increíble uso de verbos en simple past, right? Porque no tenemos uno ni dos, tenemos un montón. En cada sentence tenemos at least one, two, or three, all right? No, at least not only two. That's the most, all right? So it's good because you are improving a lot your speaking. Al hacer estos readings y al tener el simple past, estamos mejorando todavía más nuestro speaking, right? Porque nos presionamos a tener que decirlo just the way it is. That's great. Let me check if I have somebody else to practice with. I'm going to have Emperatriz, please. You read the information about Kelly. And Genevieve, you will read the information about Rob. Action.
Okay, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I had a great weekend. I went to my best friend, Helen's wedding. She got married at home. All her friends and family went. We looked fantastic. He wore a beautiful dress. After the ceremony, her parents served a wonderful meal. I'm really happy for her. I really like her husband.
Excellent. Thank you.
I had an awful weekend. My friends and I went to a rock concert. I had a terrible time. It took 3 hours to drive there. I didn't like the music at all. And after the concert ended, our car broke down. I called my parents and they came and got us. We finally got home at 10 this morning. I am so tired.
Excellent, thank you, very good. Now this one, yo creo que esta de got us es bastante dificilita, así que es got us, right? Lo pueden decir como unido, got us, right? And they came and got us. Now let's go with the third paragraph. Let me look for Karen Martinez, please. You will read the information about Erin.
I have an internship weekend and I went camping for the first time. My friend took me. We left on Saturday and drove to the campsite. First, we put out the tent. Then we a fire, cooked dinner, and told stories. We got up early on Sunday and went fishing. I caught a fish. I didn't really like camping, but I learned a lot.
Okay, repeat after me. Learned.
Learned a lot.
Learned a lot. Excellent. Very good. Thank you. All right, everybody. That was just like a warming up, right? Eso es como un calentamiento porque ahora vamos a seguir con los... seguimos en el past, pero ahora vamos con el be, all right? Statements with be. With the past of been. Ustedes recuerdan que antes de ver el simple present, en los cursos ustedes vieron el verb to be, ¿verdad? Right? Es una cosa aislada, es un tiempo gramatical aislado del simple present. Lo mismo es aquí. Ya vieron el simple past, ahora vamos a ver el tema aislado que es el statements with the past of be, el pasado del be. Ya saben que be es cero estar, right? Y cambia y se maneja diferente en cada contexto. Okay, so let's move on. Conversation. I was born in Korea, right? So let me got it for you and then you go alone. Where? Suena casi igual, right? No se vayan a poner nerviosas. Where were you born, Melissa? I was born in Korea. Oh, so you weren't born in the US. No, I came here in 1999. You were pretty young. Yes, I was only 17. Did you go to college right away? No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first. Well, your English is really good now. Thanks, your English is pretty good too. Yeah, but I was born here, right? So now you can check the information. Antes de que pasen, ¿tienen alguna duda de cómo se pronuncia algo? Pueden preguntarme ahorita. No doubts?
No.
Very good, very good, excellent. Sí, les estaba dando unos minutitos para que la leyeran y me dijeran si había algo. Okay, so let's get started. Let's see. Having this type of conversation, it's so fascinating because you are putting into practice the content, and that's amazing. So let me have Lady Ventura. Can you please be Chuck and Maria Sigüenza? You are Melissa. Action.
Where were you born, Melissa?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the USA?
No, I come here in 1999.
You were pretty young.
Yes, I was only 17.
Did you go to the college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years here.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks, your English is pretty good too.
Excellent, yeah. There you go. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. But I was born here.
Excellent. There you go. Thank you. I'm sorry, lady. Ni yo me había pegado la última.
Don't worry.
Okay. Excellent, girls. ¿Cómo sintieron esta conversation, lady and Mary? ¿La sintieron muy difícil la pronunciation?
No.
Okay. Okay, excellent. Yes. Porque aquí, si se fijan, no vamos cambiando los verbos porque ya tenemos nuestro verb to be, que es el que ha cambiado a past, right? Ya vamos a ver cómo se va desarrollando eso. Excellent, pero lo hicieron muy bien. No mistakes, we're doing good. Let's go with Isis Reyes. Isis, you are Chuck. And Anita, you are Melissa. Action.
Where were you born, Melissa?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the US?
No, I came here in 1999.
Mm-hmm. You were pretty young?
Yes, I was only 17.
Did you go to college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thank you. Your English is pretty good too.
Yeah, but I was born from here.
Excellent. Very good. There you go. Good mood, good fluency, good pronunciation. Excellent. Now let's go with Gloria Mena, you are Chuck, and Karen Heyman, you are Melissa. Action.
Where were you born, Melissa?
Hello, Karen.
Ya dijo Chuck.
Yes, ya terminé en
México. No escuché. Okay, I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the USA?
No, I came here
1999.
1999.
You were very young.
Yes, I was only 17.
Did you go to college right away?
No, my English was very good, so I took English class for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks. Your English is very good too.
Yeah, but I was born here.
Excellent. There you go. Bravo, girls. Now, let's see, Karen. Solo Karen, repita estas dos palabras después de mí. Wasn't.
Wasn't.
Mm-hmm. And classes.
Classes.
Excellent. There you go. Thank you, Karen. Miren, la verdad es que en la conversation yo entiendo que la chica le diga que su inglés es pretty good porque si no le va a cortar mal el cabello, right? No se puede arriesgar a decirle que no. So, it's interesting. Now, let me have... Jenny, you are Chuck.
And... Mi mamá. Bueno, después de...
Oh, Jesus. And let me look for Melissa. And... Karen Martinez, you are Melissa. Action.
Where were you born, Melissa?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in US?
No, in the US? I can't. No, I came here in 1999.
You're very pretty young.
Yes, I am, was only 17.
Did you go to the college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks, your English is very, very good too.
Yeah, but I was born here.
Excellent, there you go, thank you. Good fluency, good pronunciation, we're doing great. Now, let's go with Vanessa Leiva, you are Chuck, y déjeme ver, Emperatriz, usted ya pasó, no. Okay, so you are Melissa, action.
Okay. Where were you born, Melissa?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the USA?
No, I came here in 1999.
You were very young?
Yes, I was only 17.
Did you go to college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks. Your English is pretty good too.
Yeah, but I was born here.
There you go. Excellent. Thank you, girls. Yes, really good. Now, let's see. What else do we have? I'm going to tell you this. If we have time at the end of the class, you will practice again this conversation, but changing role plays, okay? Because we need to practice a lot the use of be in simple, in past, be in past, okay? So there you go. We have statements with past of be. Let me move it over here. I was born in Korea. Something that I want to tell you guys. Let me check. Aquí donde dice US, si tenemos solo US, dice United States, right? US. Pero si ya tiene la A, sería USA, y ahí sería United States of America, right? It changed. Let's go with this one. Statements with the past of being. I was born in Korea. You were pretty young. She was 17. We were born in the same year. They were in Korea in 1998. That's the affirmative part. Let's go to a negative. I wasn't born in the US. You weren't very old. She wasn't in college. We weren't born in the same country. They weren't in the US in 1998. Then you have the contractions. Wasn't equals was not. Weren't equals were not. Ya vamos a ver con qué subjects vamos a ir trabajando cada uno de estos. Lo tengo, he desplazado cada parte para que ustedes la vayan copiando. Pero ahorita solo vamos a practicar con esto. Let me see, let's have... let's see, Kahn and Heyman. You are the affirmative. Emperatriz, you are the negative. Y vamos a ir uno y uno, please.
Okay. I was born in Korea.
I wasn't born in Greece.
You were very young.
You weren't very old.
She was 17.
She wasn't in college.
We were born in the same year.
We weren't born in the same country.
They were in Korea in 1998.
They weren't in the USA in 1998.
There you go, excellent. Very good. Let's go with Karen Martinez. You are affirmative. Anita, you are negative. Action.
Okay. I was born in Korea.
I wasn't born in the US.
You were pretty young.
You weren't very old.
She was 17.
She wasn't in college.
We were born in the same year.
You weren't born in the same country.
They were in Korea in 1998.
They weren't in the US in 1998.
There you go. Excellent. Thank you. Let me go with another pair. I'm going to have Genevieve, you are affirmative. Vanessa Leiva, you are negative. Action.
I was born in Korea.
I wasn't born in the US.
You were pretty young.
You weren't very old.
She was 17.
She wasn't in college.
We were born in the same year.
We weren't born in the same country.
They were in Korea in 1998.
They weren't in the US in 1998.
Excellent. There you go. Thank you, girls. Let's go with Lady. You are affirmative. And Maria Sigüenza, you are negative. Action, please.
I was born in Korea.
I wasn't born in the US.
You were pretty young.
You weren't very old.
She was 17.
She wasn't in college.
We were born in the same year.
We weren't born in the same country.
They were in Korea in 1998.
They weren't in the US in 1998.
Mm-hmm, that's correct. Excellent, girls. Let's go with Gloria. Let's see, Gloria, you are affirmative. Isis Reyes, usted todavía no ha pasado, right?
No.
Okay, you are negative. Action.
I was born in Korea.
I wasn't born in the US.
You were very young.
You weren't very old.
She was 17.
She wasn't in college.
We were born in the same year.
We weren't born in the same country.
They were in Korea in 1998.
They weren't in the US in 1998.
That's correct. Excellent. There you go. Now, what are we going to do next? With this, we are practicing the use of past of be. But as everything in life, we need to know the structure, right? So let's see, guiding structure. Anita, can you please read the guiding structure?
Okay, subject plus was where plus complement.
There you go, simple as that, right? Así de simple, solo van a tener su subject plus was, si necesitan utilizar el was, y si no, adherimos el where plus complement, right? Copy this structure on your notebooks, please. And let me know when you're finished. Okay, I'm assuming you already finished. Let's move on with the next one. It says guiding examples. Aquí dice guiding examples, pero no con oraciones. Ya les voy a poner esos. Ahorita es el guiding example de la estructura, básicamente, right? Cuando decíamos los subjects, ¿con qué subjects vamos a utilizar cada uno específicamente? So, let me see. Karen Heyman, please tell me the subject pronouns for where. ¿Cuáles son los subject pronouns para where?
I, you, and they.
That's correct. Excellent. And Genevieve, what are the subject pronouns with was?
I, he, she, it.
And that's it. Excellent. Very good. Thank you, girl. All right. Copy these on your notebooks, please.
Teacher, y el we, el pronoun we.
Aquí está, mira, aquí va en el where. Excellent, thank you. We where.
Teacher, y el I va en where y en was.
No.
Listen, I will tell you something. En la estructura, en realidad, solo debería ser con was. Pero también a veces ustedes, lo voy a borrar de aquí, not to get you confused. Pero sí hay bastantes personas que lo utilizan con el where. Y cuando digo personas, me refiero a los nativos del idioma, right? Ellos a veces lo utilizan con el where, dependiendo de su context. Pero lo correcto es I was, right? That's the correct one. And there you go. Now, let me tell you something. Let me explain you something. Les voy a explicar algo. No sé si a ustedes ya se los expliqué. Si ustedes recuerdan el verb to be, cuando hacíamos preguntas decíamos, is she, ¿verdad? Is she your friend, right? Los natives, ellos pueden cambiarlo y decir, she is your friend. Ellos solo le dan la entonación y para ellos así ya cambia, right? Entonces, esos son los tipos de cambios que sufre el idioma, right? Dependiendo de quienes lo estén pronunciando, right? Les voy diciendo estas cosas para que no se vayan a extrañar al ver un TV show y me digan, Miss, pero eso no lo aprendimos. Yes, you already know. All right, let's move on with this one. Guiding examples. Ahora sí, aquí están los guiding examples. We have example number one. Isis Reyes, please.
Alejandra was a good doctor.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. She passed away. Alejandra ya no es a doctor, right? Let's see. Thank you, Isis. Let me have Gloria Mena, number two.
Pablo was a very good friend.
Exactly. Thank you. Maria Sigüenza, number three.
My friends were noisy last night.
Exactly. There you go. Emperatriz, number four.
Okay. Mateo was in the party yesterday.
Excellent. There you go. A ver, chicas, let's check this one. Si yo digo Alejandra, ¿a qué subject pronoun equivale?
She.
Excellent. If I'm talking about Pablo, what's my subject pronoun?
He.
Excellent. If I say my friends?
We.
I am.
They.
Excellent. Exactly. No puede ser el we porque yo no estoy ahí, all right? El we solo es cuando ya estamos ahí nosotros. My friends equals they. En Mateo?
I.
He.
Yes, me.
No, he. He. Mateo equals he. Es un él, right? Pues estamos hablando de un hombre o un chico, un joven, whatever. Pero es una persona del género masculino, right? He. Se los puse así para ver cómo distinguimos estos subject pronouns y está muy bien. Excelente. ¿Quieren copiar estos examples?
Yes, teacher.
Okay,
no, teacher.
No, yo no los quiero, diga. All right. Yes, because then you will go to practice. Después les toca a ustedes practicar.
Yeah, miss. Finish.
You're welcome.
Teacher, what is number three? My friends were noise last night. Noise.
Noisy.
What is?
Noisy es ruidoso.
What is?
Noise es ruido y noisy es ruidoso.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, I have a question for you girls. Do you have a question or a doubt so far about the past of be? ¿Alguna duda o consulta antes de ponerlas a practicar? No? All right, excellent. Let's move on. Let's move on to the practice time. Let me see, Anita, please tell me the instructions.
Okay, number one, work as world class. And number two, create two sentences with the past of be in affirmative. Number three, enjoy the activity.
Excellent, there you go. Okay, so only two sentences, please. If you have questions or you need help, I'm here, okay? You let me know. Ahorita solo estamos con el affirmative, ¿ok? Two sentences with affirmative.
Finish.
Excellent, very good. Thank you, lady. Ya la voy a poner a practicar, lady, solo quiero explicar esto, right? En el caso de Emperatriz que me envió esta sentence, you said Karen was playing softball on Monday. Okay? Monday 21st. ¿Son dos sentences o solo una, Emperatriz? Dos, ¿verdad? Okay. So, Karen was playing softball. Aquí, Beatriz, ya entra otro tiempo gramatical, que es el past continuous, right? Past continuous, que es el verb to be in past, y ya el verbo que le continúa, que sería play, va en continuo. Karen was playing softball. All right? Por eso no estaría muy correcta esa sentence. En cambio, la otra dice on Monday 21st,
I was eight.
No, igual, de igual manera, necesita el ing, ya necesitaría el ing ahí. I was eating pupusas, yo estaba comiendo. Es que decir comer, comí, perdón, es diferente a decir estaba comiendo.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome, honey. All right, now let's check. Si ustedes se fijan, solo voy a decir esto antes de moverme, right? En la estructura, no nos pide que pongamos otro verb, right? Porque ya ese tiempo es otro tiempo gramatical, cuando ya lleva otro verb. Lo mismo si se fijaron en la, in the conversation, no llevaba otro verb. Let's check these ones, chequemos estas. Tampoco, right? Born wasn't a verb. Pretty is an adjective. 17 is a noun. Born again, it's just part of the complement. Korea is a noun. And in is a preposition. Ninguna tiene un verb, right? So there you go. Now, let's see, lady, tell me your sentences.
My roommates were in the apartment last Sunday.
Excellent, that's correct.
Your parents were in Brazil in last summer.
Last summer, excellent, yes.
Is the same, the last summer or the past summer?
No, solo tiene que decir, your parents were in Brazil last summer. No necesita el de.
Okay, thank you, miss.
You're welcome. There you go. Y past summer, lady, no aplica, tiene que ser last summer.
Okay, means.
Let's go with Maria Sigüenza.
My son was a good student.
Mm-hmm.
Next, my parents were happy yesterday.
There you go. Excellent. Simple as that, right? Very good, Mary. Thank you. Somebody else, alguien que ya finalizó y para chequear sus sentences.
Me teacher.
Excellent, Karen. Tell me.
Guillermo was a good better. Bet.
A good bet.
My dog found a good pet.
A pet.
My friends were at the beach on Sunday.
My friends were at the beach on Sunday.
Well, yes.
Yes, it's correct.
Okay.
Excellent. There you go. Yes, porque está diciendo estuvieron, all right? Excellent. There you go. Now let's see. Oh, estaban también. Let me see. Let's have somebody else, otra voluntaria que ya haya finalizado sus sentences.
Me, teacher.
Excellent, Gloria. Tell me.
I was Chet Hongwar.
I was?
Chet Hongwar.
Ajá. Check es un verb.
Sí, va. Check.
Ya te,
para sí, revisar, bueno. Revisar tareas. Check homework.
No se puede. Ahí tendría que decir, I was checking homework. Yo estaba revisando tareas. Ya es otro tiempo gramatical.
Entonces la otra es, I was cook vegetable.
Lo mismo, cook. Me puse cook, que otra vez. Ajá, sería cooking. Ya ese es el pasado continuo.
Ajá.
Y ahorita, you need to learn how to form these sentences. Ahorita es necesario que aprendamos cómo utilizar el verb to be en pasado, porque después pasan a otros tiempos gramaticales y ya van a llegar al past continuous, al pasado continuo, que sería el yo estaba haciendo. Ajá, let's see. Por ahí escucho a alguien que dijo una duda. Ajá.
En los ejemplos que usted ha dado de guiding example, Alejandra was a good doctor. En español, ¿cómo dice ahí?
Alejandra fue una buena doctora.
Gracias.
Excellent. There you go. Sí, si se fijan aquí, no he puesto ningún verb porque no se puede. El cero estar no va conjugado con verbs. There you go. Another volunteer?
Me.
Excellent. Let's see. ¿Quién es me? No me aparece por aquí. Ah, Beatriz. Excellent. Let's see.
Fanny was a good student.
Ajá.
Tom was in beach last Saturday.
There you go. Excellent.
Thank you.
You're welcome, honey. Another one?
Me, teacher.
Let's see, Anita.
Porque sí, yo me había confundido también.
Ay.
Yo estaba utilizando verbos. Ajá.
Ajá, exactly. Miren, ajá. Por eso dicen, yo no sé si ustedes ya han escuchado, pero dicen que el verb to be puede llegar a ser un poco más complicado que otros tenses, porque uno piensa que puede conjugar otros verbos con el verb to be y se da cuenta que no se puede. All right, let's okay. Check.
Vamos a ver. I was... se puede decir I was in weekend.
¿Dónde estaba?
Tengo que decir. Weekend. Tengo que decir dónde estaba.
Ajá, exactly. Y no quiero, diga.
Ok, ajá. I was in weekend.
I was at
in my house o dónde. Ajá.
Puede decir I was at home on the weekend.
I was. At home.
At home, exactly.
Home, in the weekend.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Okay. My sister was with my mother. No.
Yes, my sister was with my mother.
Okay. My husband was a USA.
Was in the USA.
Uh-huh.
Yes, yes, that's correct.
Okay.
That's correct, there you go.
Okay.
Excellent. ¿Alguien más?
Me, teacher.
Let's see, Karen. Excellent.
Marcela was a good teacher.
Mm-hmm.
My classmates were good friends.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Yes,
my grandmother was a good cook, but she died last year.
Ah, ok. En ese caso voy a poner cooker, right? Fue una buena cocinera. She was a good cooker. But she died last year, dijo, right?
Last year, exactly.
Okay, excellent. I'm sorry, Karen, but very good sentences. Now, there, there you go. ¿Alguien más? ¿Alguien más? Porque ya vamos a pasar al negative.
Me?
Okay, this is excellent.
Number one, I was in class yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, my mom was at the supermarket on the weekend.
There you go, excellent. Ya se dan cuenta que cuando están formando sus sentences y ven que no es necesario otro verb, se les hace más fácil, right? Pueden utilizar prepositions of place, pueden utilizar nouns, adjectives. Tienen otras cositas que ustedes han ido aprendiendo como vocabulary. Las pueden poner en práctica aquí y ya se les va a hacer más fácil. Now, let's go, girls, to the guiding structure for negative statements. Lady, can you please tell me the structure?
Yes. Subject plus wasn't, weren't, plus complement.
There you go. Excellent. Thank you. Right? Tenemos la opción. O utilizamos wasn't o utilizamos weren't. Y lo mismo. Solo el subject. Cualquiera de esos verb to be y el complement. Easy peasy. Right? Copy this on your notebooks y de esta sí les voy a dar un solo de los guiding examples. Okay, now let me move on. Guiding examples. I wasn't very friendly. No fue muy amistosa, right? I wasn't very friendly. Friendly es amistoso. Kathy wasn't happy last week. Kathy no estaba contenta la semana pasada. We weren't at home this morning. No estábamos en casa esta mañana, right? Those are the guiding examples. Los leí yo y les tocaba leerlo a ustedes. Let me see. Karen, please, read example number one. Karen Heyman.
I wasn't very friendly.
Mm-hmm. Excellent, thank you. Gloria Mena, number two. Gloria, are you there? Maybe she's busy. Emperatriz, number two, please.
Kathy wasn't happy last week.
Exactly. And Vanessa Leiva, number three.
We weren't at home this morning.
That's correct. Excellent. Now, your time, my dear students. Time to practice. Let me see. Karen Martinez, can you please read the instructions? Me lee las instrucciones.
Okay. Time to practice. One, work individually. Two, create at least two sentences with the past of the negative. Three, ask questions in needed, if needed.
Mm-hmm.
Four, compare your sentence in with the class.
Excellent, there you go. Cuando dice en el number three, ask questions if needed, se refiere a que pueden preguntarme si necesitan ayuda, right? O si es necesario. Ahorita solo van a hacer two statements in simple, in past. Be negative in past.
Me?
Yes.
Emperatriz. We weren't in the garden.
We weren't in the garden, uh-huh.
the sky wasn't cloudy.
There you go. Excellent. The sky wasn't cloudy. Excellent.
My nephew, sobrino in English, nephew.
Nephew, huh?
Nephew wasn't sick yesterday.
Wasn't sick yesterday. Ajá. All right, there you go. Eso significaría, Emperatriz, que cumplió años, pero no fueron 6 años, right?
No, sick, de enfermo.
Ah, sick. My nephew wasn't sick yesterday. Yo le escuché sick yesterday. All right, excellent, Emperatriz. There you go. Miren, me hacen falta lentes, me hace falta el rato el aparatito también. Jesus. All right, let's see.
Finish, please.
Let's see, tell me. Lady?
Okay. Joseph wasn't very tired. Mm-hmm.
Check, correct.
They weren't in my birthday.
And you are angry for that. They weren't in my birthday.
Yes.
Excellent, lady, very good. Si no estuvieron, pero le dieron regalo. Let's see.
Okay, one more.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't in the church.
In the church?
Yes, iglesia?
Mm-hmm. Church.
Okay.
Excellent. There you go, lady. Very good. Somebody else? ¿Alguien más que quiera decirme sus sentences?
Me, teacher.
Let's see.
They weren't hungry.
Mm-hmm. They weren't hungry.
He wasn't wearing a jacket.
He wasn't wearing a jacket. No estaba utilizando una chaqueta, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Pero ella me lleva otro verb.
Sí.
Yes, exactly. Right. Sí, está bien. Imagínense cuando lleguen ahí al pasado continuo. No les va a costar porque ya llegan aquí la mayoría.
Pero la primera sí, ¿verdad?
Yes, the first one.
They weren't hungry.
They weren't hungry, exactly.
Okay.
¿Se acuerdan las prepositions of place y las giving directions? También puedo utilizar eso, ese vocabulary. For example, my husband wasn't in the corner of Main Street, right? Entonces ese vocabulary les va ayudando y ustedes solo tienen que ponerlo en conjunto. Let's see. También los vocabulary de medicines, right? I wasn't sick. I wasn't tired, I wasn't happy. Karen Heyman, veo que tiene su micrófono encendido. ¿Quiere participar?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Rosa wasn't ready for class.
Wasn't ready.
Ready.
Uh-huh.
The sushi weren't delicious.
Repeat again.
The sushi weren't delicious.
The sushi was delicious.
Yes. ¿Había escrito el weren't?
Había puesto el weren't porque son un montón de rollitos, me imagino, right?
Yes.
Yeah, but no, the sushi was, porque solo es una comida. There you go. Somebody else, alguien más, ya nos quedan unos segunditos. Ya se cumplió. Okay, girls, let me see. For tomorrow's class, we are going to check the other ones that didn't pass today, las que no pasaron ahora, mañana vamos a chequear esas sentences, y a partir de ahora pueden comenzar en su section 5, right? Mañana vamos a desarrollar bastante contenido relacionado a la sección, y pues, I will see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, girl. Bye. Bye. Care.